In this video, we're going to practice taking the derivative of inverse trig functions by taking the derivative of the expression shown here. So this is the derivative of the cosine of the inverse sine of 4x. So we're definitely going to need the formula for the derivative of the inverse sine. So let me write that in the corner for us to reference. So the derivative of the inverse sine, which is also referred to as the arc sine, it equals 1 over the square root of 1 minus x squared for x's between negative 1 and 1. And that's because if you plugged in, for example, 2, then you'd get a negative under the square root in the bottom, so that would not be a real result. So this is only for x's between negative 1 and 1. But anyway, let's use this formula to take the derivative of the expression that we have over here, the cosine of the inverse sine of 4x. So this is kind of a nested function here. So we're going to have to use a chain rule, and actually we're going to have to use it multiple times. But we, as always, want to start kind of with the outermost function and work ourselves in. So first let's think about taking the derivative of the cosine. So here we have the cosine of the inverse sine of 4x. So the inverse sine part is our inner function and the cosine is our outer function. So hopefully you remember that the derivative of the cosine is negative sine. And also hopefully you remember the chain rule, which tells us how to take the derivative of compositions. So when you're using the chain rule, you take the derivative of the outer function, evaluate it at the inner function, and then multiply that by the derivative of the inner function. Okay, so in this case, our outer function is cosine, and the derivative of cosine is negative sine. And I want to evaluate it at that inner function, so I just keep the inner function inside. So here I end up with negative sine of the inverse sine of 4x. But I need to remember to multiply by the derivative of the inner function. So by the derivative of the inverse sine of 4x. Okay. So now our next mission is to calculate this derivative, the derivative of the inverse sine of 4x. So now we have the formula for the derivative of the inverse sine. Now because I have the 4x in there instead, once again I'm just going to have to use a chain rule. So I'm going to keep this negative sine of the inverse sine out front for now. We'll deal with reducing that in a minute. Okay, so the derivative of the inverse sine, so I'm going to have 1 over the square root of 1 minus, now my inner function in this case is 4x, so I want to keep my inner function in there. So this is going to be 1 minus the quantity 4x squared. Okay, and remember to square that whole quantity. And then times the derivative of the inner function 4x. Okay. So let's finish taking all of these derivatives before we go back and simplify anything. So last of all, then, I have the derivative of 4x, which is just 4. Okay, so now all our derivatives are taken. Let's simplify this expression. Now this first part, the sine of the inverse sine of 4x, since a sine and inverse sine are inverses, then that actually cancels out really nicely, and I'm just left with negative 4x from that piece. Now here I have, for my fraction, I can write this as 4 on the top, and then on the bottom, the square root of 1 minus 16x squared, if I distribute that squared. And this can be written, finally, as negative 16x over the square root of 1 minus 16x squared. And that's our final answer.